Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay. Today in this video I'm going to giving a demo on CDMA modulation and demodulation trainer, in which we are going to see the two basic techniques of CDMA modulation and demodulation, which are direct frequency spread based and also the frequency hopping spread based. So both the techniques will be easily combined with this trainer kit so that we can easily practically demonstrate the both techniques with the help of direct PN sequence generation. Also, we will see the concept of PN sequence generation, data generation using the trainer board. Inbuilt circuits are provided for that. And also, we will see how the CDMA modulation and demodulation work with both type of techniques. So CDMA is basically a technique or a multiple access techniques, or we can say that, which basically based on the spread spectrum communication technique. In this technique, the message signal is spreaded over a wide bandwidth by using a fixed resource code so that interference is decreased and the users can be easily differentiated, so the efficiency of the communication system is also increased due to this technique. CDMA technique also does not require the multiple access of frequency and time domain, so it improves the capacity of the communication system as well. Also, the users are discriminated through the two specified code so that the users can easily differentiate from each other. So there are two basic methods of spreading the message signal through the CDMA technique. The one is frequency hopping technique, and also the second one is the direct sequence spread spectrum technique. So we'll discuss first the frequency hopping technique. In the frequency hopping technique, data is transferred as a narrow band signal with a bandwidth only wide enough to carry the required data rate. Then, at some specific interval, this narrow band signal is hopped or moved to different frequencies within the allowed frequency band. And also, it differentiates through the pseudo random pack techniques. The frequency hopping is followed as per the pseudo random technique or a pseudo random code, which is also known as to both transmitter and receiver side, so that the frequency at which the signal is hopped in a sequence, the sequence should be properly known to the transmitter and receiver, so that the message signal at the different frequency hopping can be easily recovered at the transmitter, through the transmitter and at the receiver end. On the other hand, in the direct sequence spread system, the message signal is directly multiplied by the pseudo random sequence with a much faster higher bit rate, so that when the multiplication output comes, the spread spectrum or the message signal and the bandwidth is easily spreaded, so that spread signal can be easily transmitted through this technique. And at the receiver end, the same pseudo random code should be multiplied with the modulated signal to recover the original data as a demodulation. So this was the basic detail about both the type of techniques. Now we move on to the trainer board, see what can we get and what we can learn from this complete trainer board. I will also explain the different parts of this trainer board, and then we will perform the experiment for both type of techniques also as given in the user manual. So this is the complete trainer board for CDMA modulation and demodulation using DSSS, direct sequence spread spectrum, and also as the FHSS, the frequency hopping spread spectrum technique. Both the techniques can be performed from demodulation and modulation from the complete single trainer board. So we start trainer description with the clock generator here. The clock generators are, there are two types of clock generator in which data clock at this point is provided. The data is generated at the 2 kHz frequency required to generate the data, and also the PN sequence, which has a higher frequency than data, should be generated as around 16 kHz with the different frequency multipliers. Then for generating the message signal as a data, the data signal can be generated using data generator 1 and data generator 2, two types of message. Both the differentiated message and different message can be generated using both the type of data generator. There are 8 DIP switches provided to provide the single digital data for different values. Using these DIP switches, you can easily transfer your data, required data, through the output terminal over here. Both the data generators are used for providing the message signal. Then we have the PN sequence generator here. The PN sequence generator is basically a OR gate type of generator with the four different types of frequency. At A point, we can get the 8 kHz frequency, at B point, the 4 kHz, at C point, 2 kHz, and at D points, 1 kHz frequency can be generated, by which we can easily multiply with the XOR gate over here and generate the PN sequence as requirement. There are two PN sequence generator, the PN sequence generator 1 and PN sequence generator 2, both works as the same. Then we have the DSS modulator 1. The DSS modulator 1 has two input AND gates and used as a DSS modulator for both channel. Input to each gate are data and PRN. The data input will be provided on this point and PRN sequence should be provided on this point. The both DSS modulator works as the same, and there is a multiplexer. It is a summing amplifier which has two signal, digital signal, which are two DSS signal. The output of multiplexer is multi-level signal that can be get on this spread data point. Then we have a multi-mixer here. There are two mixers for DSS and FHS, both the type of signals. The both DSS modulator 1 and DSS modulator 2 output can be combined using this mixer, and output can be fetched from the DSS output so that both different types of signal at a one communication wideband frequency bandwidth is passed through the mixer output. Then this is the DSS demodulator. The demodulator is a correlation receiver type. Demodulation consists of ending the multi-level signal with the desired channel PRN sequence. So we require to input the DSS modulator output for both the channel mixer, and the PN sequence should be provided at which or whatever the data with the PN sequence is required to recover. So if you want to recover the data generator 1 data, so that the PN sequence 1 generator should be connected here, and if you require to recover the data of data generator 2, so that PN sequence 2 should be connected on this demodulator section. Then for FHSS technique, we have frequency synthesizer 1 and frequency synthesizer 2. The frequencies of the hopping channels are 128 kHz, 64 kHz, 32 kHz, and 16 kHz. The hopping orders of the hop channels are selected according to the PRN sequence applied to the frequency synthesizer. Also, the same time, no two hopping channels can be the same. We have product modulator, FHSS modulator 1 and FHSS modulator 2. This modulator modulates the data signal with the frequency synthesizer output. So the output of the frequency synthesizer will be connect over here, and data should be connected over here. Then we have the multiplexer for FHSS as well. This is a simple linear analog adder which adds two frequency hop data and transmit the output from this output point. Then at the FHSS demodulator, we have to provide the output of FHSS modulation and PN sequence from the frequency output, which is a synthesized output from the frequency synthesizer, and then the data should be recovered as required frequency synthesizer 1. If you want to recover the data of data generator 1, then you have to connect the frequency synthesizer output 2 if you want to recover the data of data generator 2. So this was the complete details about the different blocks. Then we have the switch faults over here to provide to and to see the different switching position, so that wherever the fault occurs, you can easily find out the different fault position by turning off the any of the fault switches. In the normal condition, all switches should be at the on position. Then this is the section for power supply. The power supply is internally connected and circuit with the regulated power supply of 0 to 5 volt DC. Then this is the LED indication when the power socket is connected and the power switch is on. This LED indicator will show you the indications by glowing up. Through that, the power supply is on. Then we have the reset switch in any condition. If the data is multiplexed or data is hanged due to communication, you can press the reset switch and you can recover the data again. Also providing the user manual with this, so that you can easily perform all the experiment by explained in the user manual. All the details and studies and all the theoretical descriptions about the CDMA modulation technique for both the type of technique, which is direct sequence and frequency hopping are given in the user manual. Mathematical analysis are also provided so that you can easily study both the type of techniques on your theory basis as well. And the order code of this complete CDMA modulation and demodulation trainer board is 40544. You can use this order code to find out the specification, to check what you can learn from this complete study, and to get the proper purchasing of this through our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. We are going to start our experiments. The first experiment or the first section, we will study the DSSS modulation and demodulation. For the experiment 1, we are going to study the data and PN sequence generation. For this, the block diagram is also given in the user manual. For the connections, you can easily connect both the types of connection and check and follow as described in the user manual. So we made up this connection as described in this block diagram, and then we follow the procedure to check different waveforms on the PN generation and also the data generation. So we'll connect two patch codes using A to IN2 and connecting C to IN1. So these are the two connections for generation of PN sequence. Data is generated according to the DIP switches provided on the front panel, and you can observe the data output at data output terminal, also the PN sequence at the PN sequence output terminal. Now we will turn on the trainer board. The switch is provided over here. As I turn on the trainer board, you can see LED starts glowing, which indicates the trainer board is now on. Now we will connect the CRO probe ground to the ground terminal like this, and we will first check the data clock on the output. So data clock is showing in the CRO. I will show you the exact frequency as well. So the frequency is showing now, which is about 1.95 kilohertz for this. Also for the PN clock, the PN clock is at the higher frequency, so this is giving right now about 15.63 kilohertz. So this is about the 16 kilohertz of the frequency. Now we will see the data generation at the data output point. We'll connect the CRO channel to the data point and adjust the CRO accordingly. Or we can auto tune the CRO. Adjust the level to see the proper data stably. Here the data is now showing in the CRO. We can also change the data by changing the DIP switch position. So right now, as I turn the any other switch position, data is changed correspondingly here. So the data we can change around as per the requirement. Now we will observe the pseudo random sequence output on the PN sequence 1 channel. For this, we will connect the ground to ground, and at the second channel we will observe the PN sequence 1's output with respect to data generated. So this is our data at channel 1, and the pseudo random sequence output generation is given on the channel 2. We can adjust the level and amplitude position. So pseudo random sequence is a combination of two different frequencies at a higher rate. Here we have got the data and the pseudo random sequence on the CRO. Now we have disabled the channel 2 and observe the different outputs of pseudo random sequence frequencies at different A, B and C and D points, and let's measure what the frequencies they are offering. So first one, or the A point, is offering about 7.8 kilohertz frequency. I will try to show you closely. So it is showing 7.8 kilohertz frequency. Now at point B, we'll observe this is showing about 4 kilohertz, 3.9. And now at point C, we are getting about 2 kilohertz of the frequency, and at point D, we are getting about 1 kilohertz of frequency for this sequence. So this is the four different frequency ranges for the PN sequence. We can generate any of the combination by using two of the different frequency, using A, B, B, C, C, D or D, A. Any of the two combinations can be used to generate the frequency of the PN sequence generator. This is the first practical of generating PN sequence and the data respectively. Now we move on to our next experiment, which is to study the direct sequence spread spectrum DSSS based modulation. In this, the block diagram and the connection diagram are given. We have to build up all, both the connections, or for the PN sequence generator 1, data generator 1, data generator 2 and PN sequence generator 2. These both will be modulated separately with the DSS modulator 1 and 2, and we will observe the output at both the respective output points. Doing up these connections, I have already done the data sequence first connections. Now we have to do the data generator 2 connections. For this, we will connect A to the input 2. Make sure this time you will connect the any of the point beside C, as the A and C are generating the sequence for PN sequence first generator. Now for second sequence, we can connect either B or D with this. We can connect B or D, A or B, any of the point, but we do not have to connect A and C for this sequence. Also, make sure you have created the different data at different points, both the data generator. So I have changed my data. So we'll observe the data again. So this is the data at the data generator 1. That we are getting here. This is the data generator 1's data, and the data generator 2 data is different from the first. So both the data should be different, and also the pseudo random sequence should also be different. So this is the first pseudo random sequence and this is the second pseudo random sequence. Both the sequence combinations are different. At the CRO that might be looking similar, but at the frequency range and frequency level sequence, both are different. Now we continue to the connections. For this, the data 1 should be connected to the data input of DSS modulation 1, at where we are connecting the data sequence 1, the PN sequence first should be also connected similarly at similar modulator. So we have connected both the data and PN sequence for the first modulator. Now we will connect the data 2 at the data input terminal of the modulator 2 and the PN sequence to the PN sequence terminal of the DSS modulator 2. Now at the output we will observe the modulated output with respect to data. So at channel 1 we will connect first the data 1 and at channel 2 we will connect the spread data of data first. So we will auto tune the CRO and we are getting the modulated data at both points. So at channel 1 we are having the data output and at channel 2 the output is modulated over the spread spectrum. So it's continuously moving. We can stop the single cycle and observe the data output. So this is how the data with the pseudorandom technique is modulated with the DSS modulator, and this is the data from the data generator. Similarly, we will observe the modulated output of DSS modulator 2 as well. For this, connect the channel first to the data input 2 from the data output 2 of the data generator and spread data for DSS modulator 2. So this is the output here you can see on the CRO screen. These are the modulated output with the modulation with respect to data. So these are the waveform that we are getting for this. Now we will perform the mixer of both the channels, DSS modulator 1 and DSS modulator 2. Then we will demodulate the data and recover the data with the PN sequence with the respective data generation. Now in continuation with these connections, we are going to build up the connections. For this, we are going to fetch this both the modulators data to the mixer so that both the data is ending to the output of DSS modulator at the single channel, and this output will be fed to the DSS modulator terminal T39 at the DSS DA modulator. Now if we want to recover the data of data generator 1, so connect the pseudo random sequence or the pseudo random sequence output of data generator 1. So we will connect the output of pseudo random sequence 1 to the data demodulator. Now we will observe the output at the demodulator section, as well as we will also observe the output of mixer. Now for the output of both the mixer, we will first observe the both demodulated output on channel 1 and channel 2 respectively. So at channel 1 we will connect the modulated output of data modulator 1, then at channel 2 we will connecting the modulated output of DSS modulator 2. So these both are the modulated outputs. We can match up
These are at both the different frequency range and different bandwidth. And we'll observe the mixer output with respect to data. So channel 2 will be connected at channel 1. Sorry, channel 2 will be connected at the mixer output. This is the mixer output of both the modulated and demodulated data. And this is our data output from the data generator 1. Now we will observe the output data from the demodulator. So at channel 2 we are getting the demodulated output data, and at channel 1 this is the message signal. You have to tune both, and we can see both the signals are almost similar depending on the phase sequence and the frequency range. Similarly, we will perform the same experiment and see the output for the sequence of second one. As we have recovering the data of data generator 1, so we have connected the pseudo random sequence of sequence generator 1. Now we will connect the sequence generator 2 for this, and we'll match the data with the input of data 2, which is approximately same for both the conditions. So that's how the data is modulated and demodulated, transmit through the DSS modulator, mixed with the mixer, and decoded with the demodulator. So this is the DSSS direct spread spectrum technique with this complete trainer board. Now we will move to the next technique. For this, we will study the frequency hopping spread spectrum as well. Now we move on to our next section, in which we will see the FHSS frequency hopping spread spectrum modulation and demodulation. For this, the experiment 1 is for study of generation of PN sequence. This remains the same as we generate the PN sequence and data in the DSSS modulation and demodulation technique. So we will again match up and generate the sequence for this as well quickly. So we have already done the connections as described similarly, so that for data at channel 1 we can get the different data by using the data inputs using this DIP switches. 8 bit data can be generated. And for the pseudo random sequence, any of the two frequencies can be matched up to make up the pseudo random sequence code for generating this. So this is the basic experiment. You can generate data and PN sequence for both the data generator 2 and data PN sequence generator 2 as well. To the next experiment, which is to study the generation of FHSS modulation. In this FHSS modulation signal, the block diagram is given in the user manual. Now we are going to use the frequency synthesizer first to synthesize the frequency hopping, and then we provide the data signal to FHSS modulator 1 and 2 as well. Then PN sequence generation from the both PN sequence synthesizer, frequency synthesizer 1 and 2 will be provided to the modulator 1 and modulator 2 respectively. Then we will observe the modulated output at both the output terminals of FHSS modulator 1 and 2. So we are going to make up the connections as described in this user manual and the block diagram. So for that, we will do the connections. Similarly, in the DSSS, as we make the connections, that for PN sequence 1 should be the different frequency combination in the PN sequence 2. So for that, we are now using A and B. In the first one, we are using A and D similarly. Now, output of the PN sequence will be provided to the frequency synthesizer 2 for the PN sequence generator 2 and for PN sequence generator 1. The output of PN sequence will be going to frequency synthesizer 1. So that's how we provide the synthesizer output. Now from the synthesizer, output will be connected to the frequency input of the FHSS modulator 1. Similarly, we will connect the output of frequency synthesizer 2 to the input for frequency at FHSS modulator 2. Now we'll provide the data for both the channels. So data 1 will be provided on the data input for FHSS modulator 1, and data 2 will be provided on the FHSS modulator 2. So both the connections for both the lines and both the communication channel has been done. Now we will observe the waveforms at different points. Now firstly, we will observe the frequency synthesizer's different points of frequencies. For this, we will connect the test point F1, F2, F3 and F4 on the frequency synthesizer 1, and same will be repeated for the frequency synthesizer 2 as well. So as I connected the test point or the channel 1 probe to the frequency synthesizer first F1, we are getting 32 kHz frequency at this point. At F2, we are getting approximately 62 kHz frequency. We'll auto tune the DSO for getting the proper output. So we are getting 62 kHz frequency for this. Now at F3, we will again auto tune the CRO. And here we are getting 128 kHz frequency for this. Now at F4, we are getting 250 kHz around frequency for this. So they are four different types of frequency hopping. Similar frequencies can be also matched in frequency synthesizer 1. At F1, 32 kHz. At F2, 62 kHz. At F3, 124 or 125 kHz, and F4, we are getting 250 kHz of the frequency. Now we will observe and compare the output of PN sequence first generator's output and the frequency synthesizer first output. For this, at the channel 1, we will connect the PN sequence first output, auto tune this. Here we are getting the PN sequence first output, and at channel 2 we will connect the frequency synthesizer's output of 1. Auto tune and match up both the following. So this is the frequency synthesized output with respect to PN sequence. Here we are getting the output similar. Also described in the user manual, so that we are getting the frequency synthesized output accordingly. Now we will see the FHSS modulator 1 output with respect to data 1 output. So that we will connect the first channel to data 1 terminal, and second channel to FHSS modulated output. For this, and adjust the volts per division and level in the CRO. So that's how we are getting the perfect
FHS has modulated output, which is a frequency hopped modulated output of data. That's how the frequency matched and hopped with different data values. This is the 8-bit data binary. So this is a close view of the complete data here. So we are getting the appropriate data output from the FHSS demodulator section. Now we'll see similar data for the frequency hopping output for demodulator 2 as well. For this, we will connect the channel 1 at data input 2 terminal and we'll observe the modulator 2 output, which is the frequency hopped output of in the CDMA technique. Now we will demodulate the output using the demodulator, FHSS demodulator, and recover the output. First, the both modulator 1 and 2 will be fetched through the mixer, then we will demodulate the output according to the setup. For this, we will have to follow the block diagram, or this is the demodulation experiment for FHSS modulation. The block diagram is given in the user manual, so we have to do connections. Till here we have done our connections. Now we will provide both the FHS modulator output to the mixer, then the output from the mixer of both the signals will be provided to FHS modulator. Then whatever the signal we want to recover, whether it is data 1 or data 2, the output of frequency synthesizer with the respective frequency synthesizer 1 and 2 will be connected as per the data requirement. So if we want to recover the data of first terminal or the data generator 1, so we will connect the frequency synthesizer output to the frequency input of the modulation and we will get the data generators 1 demodulated output. For this, we are going to connect the both mixer demodulated output to the channel 1 and channel 2 of mixer, and output of the mixer will be connected to the FHSS modulator output. These are the connections. Now if we want to recover the data, first data generator, so we'll connect the frequency synthesizer first output to the FHSS modulator. Now at channel 1, we will observe the data 1, the signal from the data first generator, and at channel 2, we will observe the modulated output. So after auto tuning the CRO, we can get the same data output. Just need to adjust the CRO and levels. So we are getting the same data from the data generated output. So this is the same data that we are getting here. Just adjusting the proper CRO tuning, we can get the proper output according to the data. So this is the demodulated output. We can also observe the mixer output at the mixer terminal with respect to FHSS modulator output. So for that, we will
connect the channel 2 at the mixer output. This is the mixer output of this FHSS modulator, and channel 1 will be connected to the FHSS demodulator output. This is the demodulator 1 and this is the demodulator 2. This is the same recovered data on channel 1, and frequency synthesizer output is connected to the first frequency synthesizer, and we are getting the same data output on the demodulator. So first one is our message signal, and on the channel 2 is our demodulated output through this technique. So that's how we demodulate using CDMA modulation and demodulation trainer. First, we have studied the DSSS, direct spectrum, and the second one, FHSS, the frequency hopping spread spectrum from this. All switches are also provided in this. The all different types of switches will give you the specified folds also given in the user manual. If you turn off the switch number 1, then data clock PN not be available. Data clock and the PN clock will not be available, so rest of the output will not be properly working. Signal not available at pin number 5 or U2. Then if you turn off the pin 2, the data 1 and data 2 output will not be available. So we'll do some of the fault condition and see how the trainer board is affected through the faults condition. Now CRO should be in the continuous waveform mode, and I am going to turn off the fault switch 2. So as I turn off the fault switch 2, my data from the data generator is not going out, and there is a fault inside the data generator as we disconnect the switch from the data generator. So we are not getting the output as well on the demodulator section. Now again turn on the switch number 2, so we are getting the data modulated output. And now we have to again synthesize the output with the data and the recovered data should be matched up accordingly. So that's how we recovered our data. Just need to adjust the tuning of the CRO to proper both channel outputs visible on the screen with same level. So that's how we perform all the experiment including DSSS and FHSS on this trainer board. Different fault condition can also be arise using the fault switches for this complete setup. So this is how I have tried to explain the complete concept of CDMA modulation and demodulation technique using direct sequence spread spectrum and frequency hopping spread spectrum. So both the type of techniques has been completely explained through this practical knowledge and practical trainer board. I hope you got the proper information and your concept about that will be properly cleared by watching this video. While working the experiment with this kit, if you find difficulties, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all type of supports. And if you like the video and you have got the proper information about that, please press like button, and also please share this video to your friends, colleagues and your classmates for that who are going to working with this type of practical industries and also want to learn about these types of things. You can also subscribe our channel on the YouTube, which is Tesca Tech, for getting the informative video with the practical information about clearing all the educational concept of yours, so that you can easily clear concept of your education theoretical practicals as well. And don't forget to press the bell button, so whenever we upload the next video, you will get the proper notification about that as well. Till then, thank you for watching this video. We'll meet soon in the next video. You can also subscribe our channel, which is Tesca Tech on YouTube, for getting the proper informative videos about your educational concept, so that you can easily clear all educational and practical information concept
with the uploaded videos on our channel. Also, don't forget to press the bell button so that whenever we upload our next video, you can get the proper notification about that as well. Thank you for watching this video. We'll meet in the next video soon.